I bid you welcome. The theater is a temple, and we are here to worship the gods of comedy and tragedy. Tonight, I am pleased to announce a comedy. We shall employ every device we know in our desire to divert you.
Something appealing, something appalling, something for everyone, a comedy tonight. Nothing with gods, nothing with fate, weighty affairs will just have to wait. Nothing that's formal, nothing that's normal, and the rest decisions to decide. Tragedy tomorrow, comedy tonight.
Comedy tonight.
Something expensive, something offensive, something for everyone, a comedy tonight. Passion and potions, constant commotion, something for everyone, a comedy tonight. Nothing with kings, nothing with crowds, bring on the lovers, lions and clowns. On a street in Rome, around and about these three houses. First, the house of Aronius, a befuddled old man abroad now in search of his children, who was stolen in infancy by pirates. That's for you, but that's for you, no interest in pirates. Character in the piece. Aronius! variety and nuance, and played by an actor as such. Well, let me put it this way. I play the part. Anything you ask for, comedy tonight. And now, the entire company.
You must never know what goes on in that house.
But I do know.
You do?
Isn't it amazing? Well, I can't stand you talking.
Oh, Sodomus!
Sister! Is this your slave?
He was parading other sisters!
Oh, believe me, master! I was not parading. This is the parade that I was brought
here. Come back here. He invited us to game with him, and in a matter of moments he had taken all our money! He was using weighted dice!
It's very funny.
He took 9 minae.
One, two, three, four. I am being cheated out of my money. I want fairly.
Scrupulous.
7, 8.
What happened to 5 and 6?
Don't get into them. 9, 5, 6.
Come, fellow pistons.
Oh, master, I should be whipped. Gently. I didn't do it for the money. I thought if I could raise enough to let me buy my freedom upon you.
Scrupulous not.
Oh, it's all I think about. I hate being a slave.
Better a slave than a slave to love.
Oh, that's easy. Love?
Tell me, master. Who is she?
Anybody I know?
Sometimes you can see her through that window.
Through that window? Courtesan? From the House of Lycus? Your parents would be outraged if they could hear you.
I don't care!
Do you know how many minae a girl like that would cost?
Worth every dram. Oh, Soulless, I would give anything for her.
You would?
Yes.
You really love this girl?
Oh, yes.
I like the way you say that. Now, you cannot afford to buy this girl, but let's say someone with tremendous cunning and guile could arrange for her to be yours. What would you give that someone?
I would give them everything I own.
Ah, but what do you own? 20 minae, a collection of seashells, and me. Right, so forget about the minae and the seashells. Just give me.
Me?
Give you? Yes, my free students!
People do not go around freeing slaves every day.
Be the first.
That's not the fashion.
Get me that girl. And if I do,
you are free.
What?
Free.
Free.
Say it again. Free.
I've often dreamed how it would be, but yet I never thought I'd be.
Once again.
Free.
When you come to think of such things, a man should have the right of all others. Can you imagine what it would be like when I am
free?
Can you see me? Can you see me as a Roman with my head unbound and singing good and loud? Free, like a Roman, having rights and like a Roman proud. Can you see me?
I can see you. I can see you as a voter fighting graft and vice.
Singing soft and nice.
Free.
Why, I'd be so conscientious that I may vote twice. Can you see me?
I can see you. When you're free to be whatever you want to be. Think what wonders you'll accomplish then.
When the master that I serve is me and just me. Can you see me being equal? My country.
I can see you being soulless, the citizen.
Oh, can you see me being? Give it to me once again.
Free!
That's it!
Free!
Yes!
Free!
Oh, no, not so fast. I didn't think. The way I am, I have a roof, 3 meals a day.
You don't have to pay a thing. You're just a slave and everything's free.
If I were free, then nothing would be free. And if I'm beaten now, what does it matter?
Free.
Can you see me? Can you see me as a poet writing poetry? All my verse would be free. A museum will have me pickled for posterity. Can you see me?
I can see you.
Can you see me as a lover, one of great renown? Women falling down. But I'll buy the House of Lycus for my house in town. Can you see me? Can you see me?
Be you anything from king to baker love cakes. You're a vegetable unless you're free. Such a little word, but oh, the difference it makes. It's the necessary essence of democracy. It's the thing that every slave should have the right to be. And I soon will have the right to buy a slave for me. Can you see him? Well, I'll free him. Well, as soon as this can move, the universe shakes. But I'll never move until I'm free. Such a little word, but oh, the difference it makes. I'll be sued as the founder of a family. You'll be sued as the pillar of society. I'll be sued as the man if I can only be free.
That's it!
Free!
Oh, yes!
F-R-E-E.
No, no, the long way!
F-R-E-E.
Right, hold! Hold, come on, let me out. Well, go on! Well, move! Ah, what a day! What a day! I come out here. If I've told you once, I've told you a thousand times. Don't fan the girls while they're still wet! But you'll never learn. You'll be a eunuch all his life.
I know that sound.
And I love it!
Oh, good morning, Agnes.
Oh, it's you. How did you come into money?
An expensive legacy. My uncle Simon, the noted Carthaginian elephant breeder, came to an untimely end. Trampled to death on the last day of the mating season. This morning I bought my freedom.
Congratulations, citizen.
With this much left over for one gross indulgence.
Oh, excellent.
I guess I'm now in the market for a lifetime companion. Tell me, have you anything lying about in there to satisfy an Olympian appetite?
Pseudolus,
friend and citizen.
I have traveled the world in search of beauty, and I can say, with honesty, that I have the finest assortment in Rome. But tell me,
what is that?
My former master. I brought him along to further his education. You see, he's tired of picture books. You understand?
Well, who better than I?
Come here, little boy.
You look! Come on, quickly, we have a buyer. Go, go, go!
Here are the fruits of my search. Behold, Tintinnabula, out of the east, with the face of an idol, the arms of a willow tree, and the pelvis of a camel.
Thank you.
present Panacea. To make her available to you, I outfit the King of Nubia, Panacea, with a face that holds a thousand promises and a body that stands behind each promise. Desert bloom, wondrous as a flamingo, life as a tigress, for the man whose interest is wildlife!
Captain arrived, okay? Soulless!
Soulless. Again, my
sight.
If there are none in the house that take your fancy at the moment, there shall soon be new arrivals, and you shall have first choice, because Zulus are a friend.
And you like us are a gentleman and a procurer.
Well,
don't worry, nothing will happen. He's a virgin too.
My name is Phidia.
Yes.
I don't know your name, but you have beautiful legs.
My name is Hera, and you have beautiful legs as well, I imagine.
I would show them to you, but they're sold.
Oh no.
Along with the rest of me, I cost 500 minae. That's a lot of money.
Oh, yes.
More than 300.
Oh, nearly twice as much.
Those are the two numbers that mix me up, 3 and 5. I hope the captain doesn't expect me to do a lot of adding.
Can't you add?
We are taught beauty and grace alone. I cannot add, spell, or anything. I have but one talent.
Hero, Martha.
Zulus! Zulus, how dare you! Raging, let's
place between an innocent boy and a... you know what?
There is something about that...
you know what?
That you do not know what?
What?
That girl, of whom you think the worst, is my...
daughter.
Your what?
My daughter, you've heard me speak of her.
Never.
I don't really like to talk about her.
That girl is not your daughter.
My sister.
Right.
I'm going to tell Karen.
The hysterium, the truth. She has been bought by a captain who's come this day to claim her.
I'm definitely going to tell his parents.
And then I go with you.
Oh, you don't want to be there when I tell them about you.
No. You don't want to be there when I tell them about you.
Tell them what about me? I'm a pinner of virtue.
I think it might be of interest to the family, their slave in chief, pillar of virtue, has secreted within the confines of his room's most extensive collection of erotic pottery. What did you get the fruit bowl with the freeze on?
Hero, I've been thinking about it, and I have decided to allow you to remain with this girl until the arrival of my captain.
Stop doing that! Get the knives covered! Master, I said we needed a brilliant idea.
Yes.
And I've been to the harbour and I've thought of one. Come along.
Are we going somewhere?
Well, you are, yes.
But where are we to go?
Away! Come on.
Wait! I cannot go.
And why can you not?
As long as the captain has a contract, I must go with him. I must honour my contract.
He had to fall in love with a religious virgin.
Oh, Venus. Why did you bring us together? I'm looking to depart us.
Be brave, Aaron.
For us, there will never be happiness.
You'll have to learn to be happy without it. This waiting is torture. Why doesn't he come and take me?
In good time, he will be taken. But not out here on the streets. Inside.
You will tell me when he comes.
Of course. I shall have a knock. Three times.
Wait. That's two. And one more?
Yes, correct.
Oh, Susan, what is going to happen?
You will go with her, I promise. Ah, here's the room. Before you go to market, one last favour.
What is it?
May I borrow your book of potions?
Oh, no, that's safe. My dear.
You can guess a nice supper, perhaps. A nice floppy head, or no really good sugar dormice. His book of potions. What we need is a sleeping potion. I'm going to put two drops in a beaker of wine, and upon hearing his head, I then show Lycus that she's died for play, and tell you to dispose of the body. Good eye to the hills, you to the boat. Brilliant.
No,
not brilliant. Just, yes! Brilliant! I forgot. I cannot read. Read the pages to me.
Fever potion. Headache potion. Passion potion. Sleeping potion. Yes.
Right, what are the ingredients? One.
The eye of an E.
That we have.
The heart of a snake.
That we have.
The cup of mare's sweat.
Ah, mare's sweat! That we have not. I'll leave that to me. You go to the harbour and give the boatman your 20 midnight. Tell him you sail within this day. I shall prepare the potion.
Well, this is exciting.
Isn't it? Go. Mare sweat. Where am I going to find mare sweat on a balmy day like today?
Sulus?
Sulus! You could have taken this to the stone cusp for me. I've dropped it, and now the nose has to be resharpened.
Hysterium will take it for me. Hysterium!
Take me. Take me.
I beg your pardon.
Take me.
Oh, one moment.
What did you say?
here, on the street if you like. Say it. Say it.
Your body is mine.
Now take me. Is that not what you want?
It has crossed my mind now.
But you must know one thing.
What is that?
Though you have my body, you shall never have my heart.
You can't have everything. Thousand thanks, whichever. Can you believe it? There's a mayor sweating not two streets from her.
Remember where we stopped.
So you've returned?
Yes.
Unexpectedly.
Apparently.
Who is she?
I shall await your bidding.
Yes, dear.
Every servant.
Every my servant?
Yes, sir, yes. Your new servant. You may. We needed someone to help.
You may. She seems very loyal.
Oh, yes, yes. And very thoughtful. And very efficient. And extremely courteous.
Maids like me are neat.
I like maids, they're neat. Something no household should be without.
Everybody ought to have a maid. Everybody ought to have a working girl. Everybody ought to have a lurking girl.
To clutter around the house.
Everybody ought to have a maid. Everybody ought to have a menial.
Consistently congenial.
And quieter than a mouse.
Up the dishes, neat as a pin. Oh, oh, wouldn't you be delightful sweeping out, sleeping in? Everybody ought to have a maid. Someone who you hire when you're short of help to offer you the sort of help you never get from a spouse. Fluttering up the stairway, shuttering up the windows, cluttering up the bedroom, buttering up the master, puttering all around the house. Tidying up the dishes, neat as a pin. Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delightful? Sweeping out, sleeping in. Everybody ought to have a maid. Someone who will fetch you your slipper will be winsome as a whippoorwill and graceful as a grouse. Fluttering through the parlour, tittering down the hallway, littering up the bedroom and scurrying in the bedroom, buttering all around the house.
A maid?
A maid?
A maid! Everybody ought to have a maid. Everybody ought to have a serving girl. A loyal and unswerving girl.
Who's quieter than a mouse? Oh, oh, think of her at the dustbin, especially when she's just been tracing about. Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delightful living in, giving out?
Everybody ought to have a maid. Daintily collecting bits of paper and strings, appealing in her apron and strings, beguiling her blouse.
Shuttering through the attic,
shuttering in the cellar,
clattering in the kitchen,
buttering in the bedroom, buttering all around the house.
A maid?
A maid?
A maid!
Everybody ought to have a maid. Someone who's efficient and reliable, obedient and pliable,
and quieter than a mouse. Oh, oh, wouldn't she be so nimble, fiddling with her thimble, mending a gown? Oh, oh, wouldn't she be delightful, cleaning up, leaning down?
Oh. Everybody ought to have a maid. Someone who'd be busy as a bumblebee, and even if you bumblebee, as graceful as a grouse.
wriggling in the ante room, jiggling in the living room, giggling in the dining room,
wriggling in the other rooms,
fluttering all around the house. The house.
Both of you are. Therefore, it is for me to instruct the girl in the niceties of housework. We shall start in my bedroom.
your son is in there.
Oh.
Sir, do you remember your friend and neighbour, Aurelius, who went abroad in search of his children who were stolen in infancy by pirates? He asked you to stop into his house from time to time.
Oh, yes. This seems a good time as any. I shall have a chat with the girl in here. Send her to me.
Sir?
Yes?
It is only my great devotion to you that allows me to speak so frankly. It is that you trudged along the road quite some way, and I feel that the great physical exertion has
Is that me?
Yes, sir.
Smell like an overheated horse. I shall have to bark.
Shall I send the girl to you in 1 hour?
At least.
Why did I ever let her in the house? I should never have listened to you.
Everything's going to be fine.
Oh, you just see her to get out of the house.
And you just see that she stays in that house. Keep calm.
Calm?
Yes, carry on.
Bring up the baggage. Fetch a rest from the harbour.
Yes.
Ah, finally. Home at last after 3 long years of searching for my children. Stolen from me in infancy. By pirates! Well, at least I have the comfort of my lonely home in my old age.
Hello, sir! Who are you?
Mysterium, sir. Servant to Senate.
Ah, yes, of course, I should have recognized you anywhere!
Everybody off the hammer, eh?
What was that?
I didn't hear anything.
Everybody off the hammer. You did not hear that eerie sound?
Eerie?
Eerie, this White House for haunted!
Eerie as if for haunted?
Sir, what I'm about to tell you is eerie.
Your house is haunted!
My house? Haunted, you say?
Yes, yes. Perhaps you ought to stay with relatives and
distant relatives.
Yeah.
No! Fetch me a soothsayer!
A soothsayer?
I must have you search my house immediately. Do I give you no soothsayer? How do you know that?
I'd be a fine soothsayer if I
could. Get into my house! Silence!
Wait. I see it. I see everything. You have been abroad. Yes, for 20 years. Searching for a child.
And all children!
A fine big boy, and a strange little boy.
A girl, a boy and a girl.
Can you find
them? Oh, certainly I can find them for you.
Well, each of them wears a ring, on which is engraved a gaggle of geese.
A gaggle of what?
A gaggle of geese, look! Here, there are only 2 others like it in the world, and my 2 children, they wear them.
How many geese? In a gaggle?
7! Sir! Oh,
then before I say the sooth again, you are to walk 7 times around the 7 hills of Rome.
7 times around the 7 hills?
And
the spirit?
It shall be gone by the time you have done my bidding.
Thank you.
To the hills!
To the hills!
This is the way, sir.
Oh.
Sir,
your gaggle?
Sir, you forgot your gaggle.
Mysterium.
Yes, sir.
Prepare my bath.
Yes, sir.
I'll soon look.
That's a little maid. Do you know what her first words were to me? She said, "Take me." And you shall, sir.
I'll try.
Yes, sir.
Remember, Mysterium, and not too hot and certainly not too cold.
Philia!
Sir!
Father! You've returned.
Yes.
Where's Mother?
Mother?
I had to return without her. Pressing business. Lovely new maid.
New maid?
Tullus told me about it.
Oh.
Be patient, my dear. I shall not keep you panting long.
Why did he look at her that way?
Why did he look at her that way?
Must be my imagination.
She's a lovely blooming flower.
He's just a sprout. Impossible.
She's a lovely blooming flower. He's all worn out. Impossible.
Just a fledgling in the nest.
Just a man who needs a rest.
He's a beamish boy at best.
Poor old fellow.
He's a child, he's too repressed, while she's full of life. Impossible.
He's a man with chronic asthma, gout, and a wife. Impossible.
Romping in the nursery.
He looks tired.
Son, sit on your father's knee.
Father, you can lean on me.
Him.
Impossible. Why did she wave at him that way?
Why did she wave at him that way?
Could there be an explanation? Women often want a father, she may want mine, it's possible.
He's a handsome lad of 20, I'm 39, it's possible.
Older men know so much more.
In a way, I'm 44.
Next to him, I'll seem a boy.
All right, 50.
Then again, he is my father. I ought to trust. Impossible.
Then again, with love at my age, sometimes it's just impossible.
With a girl, I'm ill at ease.
I don't feel well.
Sir, about those birds and bees.
Son, a glass of water, please.
The situation's fraught. Impossible
possibilities.
Son, it grieves me to see a boy of your age moping about the house. Silas! I'd like you to take Hero to the baths.
Yes, sir. Allow me to finish preparing a broom, Master Hero asked me to prepare. You are to meet me in front of the baths. You know what I mean? And I shall have a surprise for you.
Yes, of course, sir.
Goodbye, Father. Farewell, Sudeness.
Well, he to his part, and I to mine. Mysterium!
Mysterium!
Yes, sir.
I shall need a complete change of garb.
Now, let me see. How about those... the tunic with the tassels?
Oh, sir, it needs taking in.
Well, take it in and bring it out.
Sudeless!
Tell me the worst. How's the girl?
She is very low.
Oh, still smiling.
No, she is now actually laughing. There is one hope. I have prepared a plague potion. If it is not too late, we may yet save her life.
Give it to her.
Yes.
Who there?
We seek the house of Marcus Lycus.
Who heats the mouse of Sucus Lucus?
Wait. Hold, sir. But he...
Who seeks the house of Marcus Lycus?
Foot soldiers of Captain Miles Gloriosus.
On whose behalf a maiden was purchased from you?
Oh, a maiden, yes.
She will be taken from the out.
Oh, splendid.
By our most illustrious Captain Miles Gloriosus.
I know that name. And I don't think I like it.
The mighty Milo to purchase a maiden from scum such as yourself some years ago. This so-called maiden, within a few months, delivered ample proof that she'd be nothing of the sort.
Accidents will happen.
Ah, but never to the great Gloriosus.
Should anything be amiss with your maiden, he will seize your entire stock and throw them to the troops.
That's fair.
burn down your house.
That's reasonable, but...
I'll send you to you!
No. No, just tell your captain that his maiden will be ready.
And very willing.
And very healthy.
With just a slight touch of clay.
What?
Nothing, nothing.
My captain has dispatched me to inform you he's but half a league away. Prepare to greet him.
Half a league?
We have but moments.
I'll give him a potion.
Yes, yes. Wait,
what?
Don't leave me!
Oh,
he's coming! Wait, you speak to him. I'll give him a potion.
You can't give him a potion.
Why not?
You'll get the plague!
I don't want the plague!
I'll give him a potion.
Good, yes. Wait, what? She's in the house of Cenex!
Oh no, no. What will we do? Does he know which house is your house?
No, correct.
This is your house.
Will he believe it?
Get the girls.
Good. You give a potion.
Yes.
I'll get the girls.
Yes.
Wait, what? I forgot.
Oh, my gosh, we mustn't lose our heads.
Yes.
No! No! We must remain calm.
Oh, Simulus, you must speak to the captain. I have no talent for bravery.
You grant me permission to represent you?
Well, can we, of course.
Oh, Simulus, thank you. You are my friend until death.
I'll get the girls. Wait!
No!
No. Over there!
We seek the house of Marcus Lycus.
Who needs the book over there?
The soldiers of Captain Miles Gloriosus. He's a quarter of a league away, and he bids you honor this.
Do you know what this is?
Oh, I know what this is.
This is writing.
This is a contract with the captain.
And a very pretty piece of work. Yes. Tell me, what does this word say there?
That is likeness.
Ah. Well, then you know with whom you are dealing.
Of course.
And do you see what it says there?
It says words. I tend to stand behind these words. Or my name is not Marcus Lycus.
Simulus?
Or my name is not Simulus Marcus Lycus.
Oh, one moment, please. A word of my eunuch.
Come here, eunuch.
That.
Oh, you know it's not true, and I know it's not true, so
how
do you care what they think? Have they come for the girl? Are you all
right? No, they haven't come for the girl. They've come for me.
What?
Some years ago, I deserted from the army.
Oh, no.
I was very young.
Oh, Simulus.
Oh, and then, Simulus, I have told them that I'm Marcus Lycus.
And Lycus, you are. Rely on me.
Oh, I must. Cyril, more bad news. The girl refuses to go with the captain, so I have prepared your sleeping potion. You are to give her 2 drops in a beaker of wine, and upon hearing me say,
present the bride,
you are to walk out with her in your arms.
Trust me, Sula. Trust me, Lycus. I go, Lycus. Farewell, Lycus.
Right. Bid your captain come. His bride awaits him. Girls!
Yes! He's right.
Eunuch!
Get the girls. Come quickly. We shall be.
Stand aside, everyone. I take large steps. We not only fought, but we won, too. There's none of the enemy left, right? Halt!
Hail, Miles Gloriosus!
You are...
Marcus
sir. I am dazzled by your presence.
Everyone is.
Yes, sir. Welcome to my house.
Great, Captain.
Your bride awaits you.
My bride? My bride, my bride. I've come to claim my bride. Come tenderly to crush her against my side. Well, let haste be made. I cannot be delayed. There are lands to conquer, cities to loot, and people to degrade. Even I am impressed. My bride, my bride. Well, come bring to me my bride. My lust for her no longer can be denied. Will convey the news. I have no time to lose. There are towns to plunder, temples to burn, and women to abuse. I am my ideal. I, Miles Claudius. I, slaughterer of thousands. I, oppressor of the meek, subduer of the weak, degrader of the Greek, destroyer of the Turk, must hurry back to work. I, Miles Gloriosus, I, paragon of virtues, I, in war the most admired, in wit the most inspired, in love the most desired, in dress the best displayed, I am a parade! My bride, my bride, inform my lucky bride, the famed arms of Miles are open wide. Well, make haste, I have no time to waste. There are shrines I should be sacking, ribs I should be cracking, eyes to gouge and booty to divide. Bring me my bride.
Here, one being is Juno, Diana, and Venus. Present the bride! One moment, sir.
What's happened?
I tell you what happened. Nothing. She won't drink.
What?
She says I'm Crete or religion for bits.
Oh. Excuse the girl. She's doing her makeup and her hair. She wants to be worthy of so illustrious a warrior.
Understandable. I am a legend in my own time. Men, sanctum. Lycus, where is my bride?
Did she not come through that door?
No. What are you saying, man?
The virgin has escaped!
Oh no! The beautiful bride I bargained for!
Vanished!
This is monstrous!
Oh, it certainly is, sir. But, look at it this way. Since I cannot deliver her to you, you don't have to pay me my 500 minae you owe me.
I paid you the 500 minae through my agent. Has the money escaped as well?
There's been a little mistake. I was only joking. Lycus will pay you.
What?
This is your man. Come out here. Come on. Tell him who I am.
Well, everyone knows who you are.
Lycus?
Of course. He is Marcus Lycus.
Oh, no, no. He is Lycus. This is his house.
Look within, sir. You will see none but the hooded men. We are a holy order, an ancient brotherhood of Lepers are clean! Unclean! And bless you,
Lycus!
What now, Lycus?
What? I shall tell you what. With axe and spear, my soldiers will raise this house to the ground!
A beautiful house!
And then you, and you, shall receive the maximum punishment! Death!
May I be allowed?
One word?
A word?
Yes, sir, just one word.
It had better be a good one.
No, it is, sir.
What is it?
Intermission!
Yes, you do. Come with me, young man. Hurry up, people want to get to the bar. Don't move, sir.
Miles Gloriosus and his mighty warriors. Cyrillus and Histidium are here, and I, Senex, await the maid in my neighbour's house, hopefully about to say my last things. If memory serves.
Let the play continue.
You deprive yourself of a face so fair, a heart so pure, a body so undulating. She is magnificence personified. So, if you were born a woman, you would have been she.
That's a magnificent respect.
Yes, sir. Spare me. I'm sure she can be found.
You are?
Oh, yes, sir. I can think of a 10 or 20 places one might look for her.
You shall go and look for her.
Me? With this bad leg.
That bad leg.
Yes, sir. It will do it good. And where shall I deliver her? Where will you be?
Waiting here, in your house.
No!
No!
I meant yes, it just came out this low.
And to assure your return, men, you are to go with him.
Before I go, a word for you, look,
be brief.
You are to put the girl on the roof.
Why?
Why not?
Go. He's not to stray from your sight.
So, and my eunuch is just making sure the house is fit to receive so illustrious a visitor.
I've been put on enough for one day.
Second time around!
Ready? The house was ready, sir. There was food and drink within.
The girls still dance for you. You have but 1 hour. Men, you are to hound his every step.
Right. Go along, men.
Histidium.
Yes, sir.
Tell the little maid I'm almost ready.
Sir, I must say this to you. Abandon this mad adventure. Just think of your wife. Away to the country.
That's Histidium. It's the country's problem.
Histidium, one more thing.
You know that potion you prepared, so filled one with passion one could almost perform miracles?
Oh, yes, sir. We've some left over from your last anniversary.
Bring it to me now,
slave in chief.
Slave in chief?
I wonder how many slaves and chiefs have a master in the top, a house full of courtesans, and a virgin on the roof.
Pretending she was dead was the perfect plan. It's still the perfect plan. If only I had a body. If only she'd taken a sip. Body. I need a body. Gusto! Gusto the body snatcher. He owes me a favour.
Since returning to Rome, I have been haunted by the premonition that my husband is up to something low. Hysteria!
Coming, master. Mistress! You're home.
I'm parched with thirst, ever fought in this city.
No, it's a potion.
What sort of potion?
To make you thirsty.
And you are really thirsty, so you don't need it.
Thirst is the lesser of my problems. This city, not the best of my intuition. I believe my husband is fouling the nest.
No.
Never. Old friend, you are talking to a woman who faces facts.
For over 30 years, I've cried myself to sleep, assailed by doubts and fears so great the gods themselves would weep. The moment I am gone, I wonder where he'll go. In all your simple honesty, you can't begin to know. Somewhere, cavorting with someone young and fair, disporting in every shameless whim. Just wait till I get my hands on him, I'll haunt him and afford him. Where is he? That dirty old man, where can he be? Profaning our vows for all to see, complaining how he's misunderstood, abusing me, if only he would. Oh, Lord, you vermin, you worm, you villain, come face, embrace your bride. Wherever he is, I know he's still an angel, my angel. Where is he? A dirty old man divine.
Of course not! His stadium here was a big help!
day I shall bend over backwards to please you.
Yes, that will not be necessary.
I do wish I could chat on with him, but I must find out why my husband was so anxious to return to Rome. You see, the next time we meet, I may be in some form of disguise. If you recognize me, not a word. Until late, Captain! Ah, Sigilis, as busy as ever.
Yes, madam.
She's back, yes.
She won't ask me then.
No, but she will, and she'll kill me.
Oh, no, she won't.
No, she won't. I kill myself. I disperse the honor of my family. My father will turn in his grave.
Oh, your father's still alive.
Oh, this will kill him. Listen. Farewell, Sigilis.
Are you finished? I've got some really shocking news.
What?
Tell Gusto, the body snatcher. He died this morning.
Well, I saw him yesterday.
When is he to be buried?
Well, they don't know. Somebody snatched the body. Why are we crying over a dead body snatcher?
Oh, he could have helped us. He could have given us a body.
A body?
Yes, a body.
A body.
Right, this theorem, would you like things to be the way they were when you woke up this morning?
In a minute.
Well, that's all it will take. Come in here.
Here?
Yes.
Where did you get the money?
Something smelled divine. And it's me. I've just taken the most luxurious bath. The oil, the essences. Spectators, I wish I could pass among you so each and every one of you might get a good whiff.
Filia!
Mustn't shout, you need to save every bit of energy.
Filia!
Ah, there you are. Come to me.
I am yours.
Yes, sir. In this house.
Where is he? He does not bring me my bride. He should see me in the height of my wrath.
There we are.
In time to say farewell.
Did my servants bring you a beaker of wine?
No. My religion forbids the drinking of wine.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Celia.
The captain. I must go to him.
I hate him.
You hate him? So do I. But I have a way to make him suffer.
No. He was in there. He had to go to the Senate for an unexpected ovation.
Really?
Yes, of course.
Does he still want me to wait on the roof?
Yes.
Leave me alone!
No. On second thoughts, I'm in the garden.
In the garden?
Yes, it's behind the large crop of myrrh.
Oh, Hero, if only you could come and buy me from the captain.
If Hero has the captain's contract, you will go with him.
Of course.
It shall be arranged. Right, come on, in the garden. Hysteria! Come out here! Come on out!
Tell me I have to be a girl!
I said girl. The captain will see you going this way and all will be well. Now help me with this. Hysteria, please! Oh, you must convince the captain
that I am a beautiful dead girl!
Yes!
You'd never believe it!
No, we won't, Hysteria. You're delicious.
Delicious? What if he tries to kiss me?
Oh, he won't try to kiss you.
How can he help it? I'm so delicious.
Oh, Hysteria. Please, just lie on the bench.
You'd never believe I'm a girl. Look at me. Just look at me.
I can't take my eyes off you.
You're lovely. Absolutely lovely. Would believe the loveliness of you.
No, no.
Oh, Hysteria, please. Winsome. Sweet and mad, winsome. As in some dream come true. Now Venus will seem tame. Helen and her thousand ships will have to die of shame. You're so lovely, literally lovely, that the world will never seem the same.
Right, Hysteria, lie down. Yeah, I think dead good thoughts.
I'm lovely, absolutely lovely. Who'd believe the loveliness of me? Perfect, sweet and warm and winsome, radiant as in some dream come true. Now, should I have some jewelry?
Oh, here, take this ring.
Flowers.
Flowers?
I should have flowers. I'm so lovely, literally lovely, that the world will never seem the same.
You are so lovely,
that the world will never seem the
I've been looking for you everywhere. Here is your captain's bride. Dead!
You'd best go tell your captain.
A virgin!
A lot of good it did her.
Oh, grievous day! Men, support me! She died.
She just sort of rolled over.
Oh, spare me. I cannot control the tears. I must cry.
Go ahead, sir.
Oh!
you've seen her, I suggest you depart and talk to yourself no longer. If you give me the contract, I shall dispose of the body.
What? I shall not leave without the comfort of a proper funeral service.
Do you have time for that? Shouldn't you fight a war somewhere?
Silence! I insist on conducting a funeral.
Yes, sir?
We need mourners.
Well, we have them.
Poor girl. Who died so young without ever having experienced me? A bridal bower becomes a burial field, a bit of a reboot.
Very good, sir. Can you say, Titus the tailor told 10 tall tales to Titania the titmouse?
Do not try to cheer me. I am inconsolable.
The horn, pluck the lute, forward morn. Ah! All Crete was at her feet, all Thrace was in her thrall. All Sparta loved her sweetness, and Gaul,
and Spain,
and Greece,
and Egypt,
and Syria,
and Mesopotamia.
Oh, why should such a blossom fall? Speak the spells, chant the charms, toll the bells,
fold the arms. Sir, on behalf of us all, I'd like to thank you for a wonderful funeral. I don't know about you, but I've suffered enough. If you give me the contract, I shall...
No! Strew the soil, pluck the lyre, spread the oil, build a pyre.
A pyre? What kind of pyre?
A pyre of fire.
Oh, a fire pyre.
She must be burned.
Burned?
I want her ashes.
Oh, sir, it is not for us to destroy such beauty. The gods would not be happy if you sent up a charred virgin.
I cannot afford to offend the gods.
Who can?
She is at her feet, but I shall weep no more. I'll find my consolation as before among the simple pleasures of war.
Bring me the contract. Now, I give her to the gods. Take her then, and lay her to rest. And I shall go on my melancholy way. Men, wait. A farewell kiss.
Of course,
that not you.
No, you mustn't!
Why not?
It could make you very sick. The truth is, she died of an illness contracted on Crete.
What illness?
The plague!
Silence! There is no plague.
What?
I return from Crete this day and there is no plague.
Oh, then what was everybody yelling about?
This girl is alive!
She's going to stay that way!
But wait! Wait! Ben! Offer her!
I'll get her!
No! Stop!
Now all the courtesans have escaped! You lack! I stand to lose a fortune!
human in flesh. Find the girls, bring them back! Ah!
I've got to get up these clothes.
Oh, there you are, my little boy. My slave has prepared a little feast, and I'd like you to serve it to me. Do you understand? See you later.
Mysterium, where is it?
I gave it to a soldier.
Oh.
He wants to meet you later tonight.
Oh. Oh, get it. I need it.
Enough!
Oh, look out!
My men, I've found her.
Well,
there she is! The virgin!
Oh, my virgin!
Sir! I am not anybody's virgin!
Yes, she made that book clear when last we met.
I can't get out of these clothes!
Hello, my dear.
Oh, yes, I know!
You're beautiful when you're angry.
I shall give my Minai to the boatman, and I shall sail with him and drink the potion and die.
Dearest Senex, you saw through my disguise.
Yes, beloved.
Forgive me for mistrusting my darling, but you have been a little distant these last 39 years.
Yes, beloved, yes.
Senex!
Senex! Three times the spirit! My dear one, my sweet one!
Why do all the men find me so attractive?
My daughter!
What?
You wear the ring with a gang of geese!
I'm not your daughter!
There she is!
Yes!
My virgin!
I'm not a virgin!
Those filthy pirates!
I am an untrusted dancer. Dancing with impatience, my dear.
Who is speaking so boldly to my virgin?
Your what?
She is my maid.
No, she's my daughter.
Please, no fighting, please.
You're not the virgin.
Of course not. I'm this old man's baby daughter. Say you're speaking to my wife!
You are married to that!
Yes, I am married to that!
Well, thank you to release my slave and remove yourself from the front of my house! Your house? But this is the house of Lycus!
Lycus?
Quiet! His head is under martial law!
Release that man!
Release that man! What? You!
Sir, this quivering wreck is blameless! It is I and I alone that have caused you grief!
Men, unseize him, and seize him. And now, death by escalation.
Sir, I do believe a doomed man is allowed one final request.
Yes?
Allow me to take my own life.
Sir, I have seen kings with less courage.
Yes, sir. Mysterium, the potion.
know the one I mean. And now, I give to sail on uncharted seas, from which no man ever returns. To the harbour! To the harbour! Farewell.
Happy as your mother and I, my heart will bleed for you.